नमस्कार, मेरा नाम आशुतोष बहुगुणा है और मैं इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पांस टीम में एज ए साइंटिस्ट डी कार्यरत हूँ। इस सेशन में हम चर्चा करेंगे नेशनल साइबर सिक्योरिटी स्ट्रेटजीज एंड पॉलिसीज। सो द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस सेशन इज टू सी ITU ग्लोबल साइबर सिक्योरिटी इंडेक्स एंड साइबर वेलनेस प्रोफाइल्स। यू विल सी हाउ कंट्रीज आर डूइंग एंड दे आर मैनेजिंग, हाउ दे आर मैनेजिंग द साइबर सिक्योरिटी एंड वट टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज दे हैव इन प्लेस। देन वी विल डिस्कस द साइबर रेडीनेस इंडेक्स, वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू अदर साइबर सिक्योरिटी इंडेक्सेज, वी विल ऑल्सो लुक इन टू द नेशनल साइबर सिक्योरिटी स्ट्रेटजीज। सो नेशनल साइबर सिक्योरिटी, मैनी कंट्रीज केम अप विद द नेशनल साइबर सिक्योरिटी स्ट्रेटजीज। That document is, those documents are placed in public domain and that define the objective and goal of a country to protect against the cyber attacks. So those are the cyber security strategies of a national cyber security strategy. Like in India, we have a Indian national cyber security policy. So and these indexes, ITU Global Cyber Security Index, those indexes is the measure of how a country is doing in terms of the cyber security and what their posture is. So it's an assessment of that cyber security posture of that country. So let's see first the ITU, the Global Cyber Security Index. So this is an index developed by the cooperative effort between ABI Research and the International Telecommunication Union, ITU, which aims to provide insight into the cyber security engagement of nations. So it gives you idea how the countries are doing in a cyber security. So that the cyber security, there is a global cyber security agenda and global cyber security index is a part of it. So in global, this ITU global cyber security index, they look for a five dimensions, five parameters. First is like legal measures. What are the legal measures in place the country for the cyber security and the cyber crimes? So then there are the technical measures. What the technical measures initiated by country and nations, and what is the progress in terms of the technical measures at a national level? Then organizational measures. What is there is an organization setup like a computer emergency response teams. And what is the progress of them? Then there is a capacity building dimensions. Capacity building in cybersecurity. So they do the assessment in that dimension. Then there is a cooperation. Cooperation is how the country is cooperating with other nations for resolving the cyber incident. So the result is the country level index and global ranking of cyber security readiness. So it provides where the country stands. They provide it index and the rank. So that's they do they convert that data into the qualitative measures. So the five parameters is the like we discussed is the legal is the first. It's the based on the existence of legal institutions and frameworks dealing with cyber security and cyber crime. So if there exists anything such as that at country, so that is the in a legal domain. That assessment is done in a legal dimension. So like in India, we have a Information Technology Act, IT Act. Technical measure is measured based on the existence of technical institutions and framework dealing with the cyber security. So whether that technical institutions like a computer emergency response teams are there or not, whether forensic laboratories are there or not, and those types of things are looked into the technical measure. Organizational measure based on the existence of the of policy coordination institutions and strategies for cyber security development at the national level. So country level, if there is a coordination institutes are there for coordinating efforts across different agencies and organizations, that's looked into the organizational dimension. Capacity building is the measure based on the existence of the research and development, education and training, the professional certification for the in a cyber security domain, whether they exist or not. And then in a cooperation, it's a measure based on the existence of partnerships, cooperation, and the information sharing networks of a nation. So on these parameters, the organization, the nation's index is calculated and then that is rank is assigned. So the global cyber security index, so the 193 countries are there. They have a data and assessment of 193 countries. So research method is primary and secondary. So they are collecting the data from the secondary sources and the primary sources by asking the nations to fill the survey and provide the inputs for the research. Then the rank and score is calculated. And in those dimension, five dimension, there are 17 indicators. Indicators means which exactly look for exact measure under that dimension. Then based on that 193 countries, along with the indexes, we have a cyber wellness profiles of country. Cyber wellness profile means how well, that's the picture of cyber security capability of a country. So cyber wellness profile, suppose for India, you can have a look on that. The cyber wellness profile, it gives you the how the country is doing in various parameters. So in a legal, in a organization, in a technical, in a corporations, in a capacity buildings. So that picture, that those details are there. So those informations are available in a public domain. You can search for a ITU cyber global cyber security index and wellness profile, and you will get a copy of that report. Then there is another index known as a cyber readiness index. So cyber readiness index is developed by Portnoy Institute for Policy Studies, and it's a the publication. So for the countries, that publications for the nations, that what are their state and their maturity in cyber security, those reports are published. So a total of 125 countries have been selected for the studies, and this publication is focused on evaluating the nation's state cyber maturity as their overall commitment to cyber issues. So that the publication is mainly focused on policy and economic aspects of cyber security, and includes fact-based assessment. So that's there. So they is supported by facts. So it's a facts-based assessment of country's cyber readiness. So cyber readiness index is there. So cyber readiness index 2.0 is having a seven indicators. Seven indicators means into the measurement in a national strategy. Whether national strategy is defined, it's documented, it's implemented, implementation label, and things like that. Then the incident response capability of a country. Then e-crime and law enforcement is there, that existence and measurement of that. Then information sharing, cooperation is there or not. So that is the measurement of that capability. Investment in R&D, research and development activities in a cyber security, that is assessed. Then there is a diplomacy and trade for the cyber security. And then defense and crisis response for the cyber crisis response in this. So all these seven domains make them calculate the cyber readiness index of the country. How a country is doing in all these seven domains. So details of that report. So suppose you want to get a report for India, that detailed report is available. You can get the Portnoy Institute website, and then academic centers and cyber readiness index. So the reports, the cyber security readiness index of reports of countries are published here. Then there are other indexes like cyber power index. So cyber power index is developed jointly by Economist Intelligence Unit and Booz Allen Hamilton. The publication is focused on policy, organization and technical aspects of cyber security. So it's look for our policy, organization and technical aspects. So different indexes are doing the evaluation on different but similar. All the dimension are more or less similar. They include the 39 indicators and then grouped into the four categories. Like a legal, then economic and social context, then technology, infrastructure and industry. So they provide the picture of that country's cyber power index of the nation. And then European Union cyber security dashboard is there. That dashboard also provide the picture, cyber security posture of the European countries. It's having the five themes like for legal, foundations, then the operational entities in that country, public private partnership, sector specific cyber security plans and education. So based on those and the assessment of those entities, create a posture of a nation. So that's the EU cyber security dashboard. So 28 European Union member states are there. Our aim of the dashboard is to provide a reference base to allow the evaluation of countries' policy in terms of cyber security against 25 criteria and the cyber security stands compared to the other EU members. So how well they are doing as compared to other EU members, and how well they are doing against the baseline, that's presented from the dashboard. The publication does not have any scoring or a ranking mechanism. National cyber security strategy. So there are papers, good papers and a report document to go through, and that I will suggest you to go through the this one OECD, this Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. So their report is that cybersecurity policy making a turning point. So at a turning point, so that's the basically that report will provide you the different national cybersecurity strategies of a country. So those are the policy document, that's the intention of a government, national government, to protect and cooperate with other countries and protect the critical infrastructure and the services operating within the country. Then there are a comparison and discussion in a paper, that's the 19 national cybersecurity strategies, that's the International Journal of Critical Infrastructure. So here is a detail of that in a slide. You can go through it and you can have a good comparison of different strategy, what is covered in one strategy, what is not, and things like that. So national cybersecurity policy in India, we already discussed in other sessions also. So what is its objective? If you look at the national cybersecurity policy, you will have an idea of the national strategy and policy for a cybersecurity. So it's the if you see, this facilitates creation of a secure computing environment and enabling advocate trust and confidence in electronic transactions. That policy also provide guide stakeholders action for protection of cyberspace, outline a roadmap to create a framework for comprehensive collaboration and collective response to issues of cybersecurity, adapt an appropriate strategy both at the national and international level. So those are the objective of national cybersecurity policies. You can get it downloaded from the Ministry of Electronics and IT websites. So that policy implementation, how that policy will be implemented. So there are a few actions which are by the government, like a regulation, advisory, and a guidelines. There are actions in collaboration, PPP mode, and there are actions by private enterprises and the action of the academia. So those action, when we collaboratively take, then we can better respond to the cyber threats and make the country secure. So those things and action plan are basically covered by the national strategies. Snapshot of efforts is two dimensions in case of a national cybersecurity policy of India, that national and international. National, what we will do, what efforts we have to take. Internationally, how we have to enhance the cooperation and coordination and information exchange with other states. There are goals are defined there, like reducing national vulnerability to cyber attack, preventing cyber attacks and cyber crime, and then reducing the time need for the response and recovery. And then effective cyber crime investigation is a goal of the cyber security policy. So in summary, so we discuss about the ITU cyber security, global cyber security index. We discuss the cyber readiness index. We discuss cyber power index, and there are other index for the assessment of the countries, how the well the countries are doing in this cyber security. So those details are available. Cyber wellness profiles of countries are there. You can have a look at the cyber profile, wellness profile of different countries at the ITU website. Then we discuss the cyber security strategy. The countries, I have given you references of paper, the document that you can use for the national cyber security strategies. We discuss the national cyber security policy of India and its goal and the plan and the dimensions of a focus. So that's all for this session. Thank you.